Welcome to Sector 2018. My name is Danny Bradbury, and this is Lily Chalaposki. She's a threat intelligence professional at GoSecure, and today she was given a talk on malware in Chrome extensions. It sounds like pretty scary stuff, Lily. So you you brought something with you today, I think, to sort of demonstrate what extensions can do if they're not properly supervised. Explain what you're going to show me.
So essentially what I'm going to show you is a Chrome extension that masquerades as a legit Chrome extension, a Chrome optimizer, for example, saying it's going to make your browser faster, when in fact that's not the case, and it bypasses some really fundamental security controls that people have set up on their website to help protect their users.
All right, so we'll kick it off and show me this in action.
Yeah, so here is just where the extension is. So what I run here is the CNC server. So essentially there's nothing there right now, but, and if I refresh the page again, there's not much too much going on. But if I come over here and enable the malicious extension, right, and refresh, now I have data coming through, right? And it's sending it out to a different location other than the actual the site where it only should restrict its data to. You'll see it says hello there in the console, and you'll notice that code here in the window for the CNC data, if I change that to something else and wait longer, it will actually change the what's coming out there in the console. And essentially what that's saying is that with this no matter what the policies are, I'm actually able to go ahead and capture any kind of data, even in HTTPS. Yeah. So here, for example, if I sign into RBC, if I open up the background page debugging, you can notice that it's removing the security headers that are actually there. So if I go ahead and type in a fake, like for example, card number, and a super crazy password, you would think that the security policies of remote websites that you go to would actually, you know, send somebody to the browser saying, you know, you can't do this. It does, but it's actually parsing all those out. You notice it also logs the key events in there as well. And if you go up and look, you see here where it says user as in card number, as well as the massive, super really long password that it captures, even when it's fully encrypted with HTTPS. So by removing those headers, it makes things quite easy.
So the browser is almost like an evil man in the middle, right?
Like kind of like an evil man in the middle. So you see here in the code where it says remove security header. You could, actually, the feature that's in there for blocking, you can go ahead and use that feature, but not for blocking, but you can actually remove and replace all the security policies that are coming in for headers, like your content security policy, cores, all of them, access protection, all of them is available to you, and you can go ahead and modify them on the fly before they're even able to be used.
Wow, that's incredible. So what should users be thinking about in order to protect their browsers from these security problems?
Check your extension page. Make sure you know what extensions you're installing. Make sure you know that it's trusted. Don't have developer mode enabled for any reason if you're not a developer and you know what you're doing. And sometimes just open up the console, Control-Shift-I, see if anything weird's happening. Also, making sure that you have antivirus installed. Hopefully that space is gonna get more tailored towards the extension ecosystem as well, where we'll see AV solutions built into the browsers, actually, in order to help find and prevent other extensions from doing terrible things.
Great, okay, well, Lily, it's been an eye-opener. Thanks so much for showing us through this and for being here today.
Yeah.